insulted that I was non-essential, and then I started, after a few weeks, I started to embrace my non-essentialism. Bless you. I would tune into like Turner Classic Movies, watch these old movies, read books I've been meaning to read and reread, and brush up on my French and my Italian, and I bought a pair of tap shoes because I was watching these old movies and saying like the Nicholas Brothers and Fred Astaire and Sid Charisse and Ginger Rogers, and I thought, well, I can tap dance with my fingers a little bit. I can tap with my feet, and it turns out that I can. But that's all right, because what I discovered was that tap shoes are like Prozac for your feet. And actually for the rest of your body too. As it turns out, I got the ugliest pair of tap shoes. I mean, they're the ugliest pair. I thought I would, I didn't know if I would stick to it. So honestly, in all fairness, I didn't get the cool looking, you know, 30s wingtips that I, you know, I'd hoped for, but yeah, it looked like I was wearing goat hooves or something, cloven hoof, tap dancer. Anyway, I would think about something and go like, oh, I gotta grab something in the kitchen. I kept them on all the time, and I would go click clop click clop click clop click clop click clop to the kitchen, right? And I'd start laughing at myself, right? Because like, I would start laughing, and I forget what I went to the kitchen for. So I go back to my bedroom thinking I could remember what I forgot if I went back to the place where I remembered it. And I get back there, and I couldn't remember what it was. And I start laughing at myself again, and it's hard. It's really hard to be depressed when you're laughing. You know? And if you can't laugh at yourself, you have no business laughing at anyone else, right? That's the end of my moralizing. That's the end of my moralizing. Hang on one second. You see, once I felt real comfortable having people over again, it was wonderful because I love making food and listening to music, playing music with my friends, and so it was kind of a surprise that after not seeing these people for a year, and they were wonderful folks, that everyone came over and we were having fun, and then I just realized I couldn't wait for them all to go home. And so I wrote a song about it, right? It's called So Much Fun. It's on the new one, and it goes like this.